breast cancer for 6 years.
Closer.
Sorry. I've been living with breast cancer for 6 years. I thought I would get through this. Apparently not. Like many facing terminal illness, I've employed a number of medical protocols to extend my life. And thanks to biomedical research, I've been given these extra years to live among you in this beautiful town. And I believe that our reckless imbalance with the environment plays a huge role in where disease comes from. I could speak to the need for stricter chemical regulations, food safety, environmental protection, but we've already reached the tipping point. Prevention is no longer our first line of defense. Treatment now plays the starring role for nearly 40% of Americans who will be diagnosed with cancer in their lifetime. And without treatment, 1 in 5 will die from it. Having once beat terminal status, I'm not just one of those numbers. I'm living proof of what research can do. So where does life-saving treatment come from? It begins with research. We've all talked about this. The majority of that research is funded by the federal government through grants. And this comes thanks to a strong bipartisan investment in public health, honestly. I don't know what the problem is. We are all affected by this. The leading agency behind it is the National Institute of Health, or NIH, which invests $48 billion each year in biomedical research, including $8 billion specifically for cancer. And the return on taxpayer investment? It's millions of lives, tens of millions more years lived. Improved symptoms, slowed or prevented disease progression. And I personally benefited from every one of these outcomes. And I'll bet you or someone you know love does too. Over 90% of NIH funding goes to research that touches nearly every family well beyond cancer. Alzheimer's, Parkinson's, MS, heart disease. It's how we've eradicated polio and smallpox, and how HIV became manageable rather than fatal. But clinical progress is now under threat. Nationally, new grants are being frozen. Existing research is being terminated. And studies that don't align with this administration's ideology is being erased. And that matters. Diversity, equity, and inclusion matter. Women are already underrepresented in clinical trials. And Black women even more so. And when you cut research in certain areas, you don't just exclude a few voices. You risk everyone's health by ignoring crucial data. And when labs shut down, you can't just pick up where you left off. You don't get to pick the petri dish out of the trash can. Trials end, data is lost, sometimes decades worth. Trial patients have life-saving medicine that gets revoked. Parents lose children. And children are left so vulnerable when they lose their parents. In February, an executive order slashed those congressionally directed medical research programs, a Pentagon program that received $1.5 billion annually, with nearly half dedicated to cancer research. It's now cut by 57%. Mark Veith of the Defense Health Research Consortium was shocked. His words, no money for cancer, kidney cancer. No money for pancreatic cancer. No money for lung cancer. This leaves so much completely unfunded. And the reason cancer is so hard to cure? Cancer isn't just one disease, it's many. Breast cancer alone, which is what I have, has so many subsets. It can be non-invasive or invasive, ductal or lobular, estrogen, progesterone, and HER2 positive or negative, or a combination of one of those three. Or it can be location-based, like Paget's disease, or metastatic, like mine, which travels to the organs and bones. There's so much to study here. And new innovations have reached the market just since I've entered this like personal nightmare of mine. And funding isn't just about today, it's about the future. Young scientists are the lifeblood of biomedical, you have my pages, research. Cuts force training programs to close, promising talent leaves the field, and the result? We have a brain drain that weakens America's role as the global leader in scientific innovation. And the economic cost of defunding is steep. In 2024, NIH funding supported 408,000 jobs nationally and generated $94 billion in new economic activity. That's a $2.56 return for every dollar spent. Research is not wasteful. It's not wasteful spending. It's smart spending. It's life-saving. It's economy-boosting investment. Research drives America's global leadership in biomedical innovation. And so I just ask you to please stand with me and for all of us to say hands off science.